Welcome everyone to another episode of AppSec 101. My name is Andrew Garrett, and I work in marketing here at Microfocus Fortify. And today I'm pleased to be joined by Matt Stanchek. And Matt has been pursuing his passion for software engineering for over two decades now. So he has a background in software engineering and in security, and he's worked in multiple industries. So he's been responsible for the design, development, and security of enterprise web technologies, as well as financial systems for top banks and software security ecosystems. And then since 2014, Matt has undertaken the task of building scalable software security capabilities for the age of agile and DevOps. So I'm really happy to be joined today by Matt. Matt, I think your background speaks for itself. You have a lot of experience, a lot of knowledge in this area. So I'm looking forward to hearing what you have to say today.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Absolutely, yeah. Well, to kick things off, maybe let's just go over a basic overview of AppSec testing. And, you know, you hear the phrase, scale your AppSec program. What does that really mean when people say, you know, you need to scale your AppSec testing?
Yeah, well, to me, it means meeting the needs of the organization. And that's in terms of awareness and coverage. Awareness can take on many forms and through different channels, but getting the word out about risks inside and outside the organization is a key first step. Then for coverage, that involves understanding the software that's built and the software that's used by the organization, as well as what's used to build it.
So let's dive into that a little bit deeper. When you're talking about AppSec programs for specific organizations, maybe you can talk about why it's important to optimize an AppSec program.
Yeah, well, my perspective is that the basic mission of an AppSec program is to identify risk in the software applications used by the organization. Risks are continually evolving on several different fronts. Specific to AppSec, well, new programming languages and especially frameworks are introduced at a really rapid pace. On the other end of the spectrum, unmaintained, aging applications, those can have previously undiscovered vulnerabilities, especially when new attack patterns emerge. So now with that in mind, consider the fact that many organizations don't have a large application security team. By some measures, there is a 1-to-40 ratio between AppSec team members and developers. In one of my prior positions, I was the only application security team member, and there were well over 200 developers in the company. Without optimization, it would be quite challenging to keep up.
Wow, yeah, that's amazing to think about. So a 1-to-200 ratio is not ideal, obviously, but there are some things that, you know, we can do on the AppSec side that can hopefully help make our jobs a little bit easier. And a lot of that comes through maturing your AppSec program. And maybe you can touch on that a little bit. What does that mean to mature an AppSec program? And what does that process look like?
Yeah, so earlier I mentioned that the basic mission of an AppSec program is to identify risk. And that's the foundational first step. What follows then is applying strategies that ultimately help the organization to reduce that risk. AppSec teams are often a pivotal component in compliance-related efforts, even when there's already a separate compliance team. So with the testing performed by AppSec, the data and results they produce, those fold directly into the compliance domain. Now, as AppSec becomes more a part of the software development lifecycle, there starts to be an inflection point where it isn't just about discussing a particular issue from a particular test or a scan. Development teams start realizing that there is another dimension to what they're building and maintaining, something they may not have put much consideration into, and that's paying down security debt and designing securely from the beginning. And that's, to me, that's a leaping off point. That's where educational programs become so important. Broad awareness through training augments the targeted help me fix this critical issue type of advice.
Okay, so once we've paid down some of that security debt, like you mentioned, and we've fleshed out our AppSec program a little bit more, what does a fully mature AppSec program look like, ideally?
A mature program. Well, not only has the basics covered, like penetration testing, as well as automated static application security testing and dynamic application security testing, but they have data. And that data can become measures and metrics. So along with an application inventory, that data can inform risk profiles and threat models too. Reporting all of that regularly to the CISO, as well as stakeholders in the development organization, can drive change and help the rest of the company mature toward a better overall security posture. Now, beyond testing and scorecards, though, it's about relationships. Effectiveness can be amplified when you forge and maintain those strong relationships. As a developer or a dev manager, would you rather partner with someone who is telling you you're doing something wrong, or would you be more willing to listen to someone who wanted to support you and provide tools as well as advice?
Yeah, and I think that's a good point. And, you know, speaking of tools, let's take a moment to talk about some of those tools. And, you know, what are some solutions that people should be looking for when they're striving to mature and optimize their AppSec program?
Well, earlier I mentioned awareness and coverage. So there are a few different aspects to each of those concepts. Let's talk about awareness first. Newsletters, brown bag sessions, and offering training courses are three great ways to build awareness. With newsletters, you can tailor those to specific areas of focus by including news articles or other helpful tips. Brown bag sessions, those are great. Those are informal ways to get interested folks to learn about AppSec topics of interest in an interactive setting. Then training, that can go a long, long way. Now this one's rewarding. It is rewarding to deliver training and then have folks come up after class has ended. They ask more questions or dig deeper into the subject matter. One application security awareness class I delivered last year was especially rewarding personally. One of the attendees went on to enroll in a nearby university security program after getting interested in it after my class. So that to me was kind of one of those butterfly effect moments. Now, another way to scale is obviously adding headcount to an application security team. That typically has limitations. First, many organizations don't fund AppSec like they do their application development teams. And let's face it, AppSec doesn't exactly make money for most companies. Second, competition for good candidates is fierce. So adding virtual headcount with an application security champions program allows a small AppSec team to extend its reach throughout the organization. There you can find interested developers, testers, and tech leads, and they can be radiators of information and knowledge.
Yeah, that's great. And I'm glad you brought up the point of training as well, because I've always thought that was crucial to any security program, because you can have the best policies, you can have the best strategies, you can have all the best tools. But at the end of the day, if your employees aren't properly trained on how to use these tools, then your AppSec program can really only go so far.
It's concepts and tools that getting those things together really, really brings everything together for everybody.
Yeah. Well, maybe to wrap things up, we could talk about some best practices. And do you have any recommendations that you would give maybe to people that are just getting started on some strategies on how to best scale their AppSec testing?
Yeah, sure. There are a few things to recommend. The first, supplying secure design standards and some standing security requirements that are enforced by policy. That's one top-down approach. Another is to work with development teams, partner with them, go hand in hand, create security unit tests. You can use known attack patterns and payloads for those. One of the most impactful strategies, though, is building application security tool automation into the DevOps process. Automatically scanning source code with something like Fortify SCA during development and build phases. You got the SDLC, which has, you know, a bunch of phases. So Fortify SCA fits great into that dev and build cycle. That gives you the ability to find issues in the code before it gets deployed. Meanwhile, scanning the open source components for known vulnerabilities using Fortify's partnership with Sonatype in parallel to that static analysis scan can round out that view of issues while the app is in a non-running state. Then once that build is deployed, that's the perfect opportunity to kick off a dynamic scan automatically with a tool like WebInspect. And that takes a look at the live environment to find the issues that maybe you couldn't find easily statically, but then it can also help you confirm those that were. Now, all of this can be driven right from the continuous integration and continuous deployment tools like Jenkins, Bamboo, and Azure DevOps.
Yeah, that's great. And, you know, hopefully to our viewers that are watching this episode, hopefully this will give them a good jumping off point for those that are new to AppSec programs. And, you know, for those that have a little bit more experience, hopefully this gives them a good look into some of Fortify's capabilities. Because honestly, Fortify has a lot of great tools, a lot of great capabilities to help people really scale their AppSec programs. Well, thanks again, Matt, for taking some time to talk with me today. And, you know, to our viewers, if you have any questions or if you have any comments, please feel free to drop them down below and make sure to join us for another episode of AppSec 101. Thanks.
Thank you.